Welcome back to the channel, it's your boy Joe Picariello. Today, I'm telling you 36 facts about the Breaking Bad series finale. This should go without saying, but if you haven't finished Breaking Bad yet, don't stick around, or else you'll be spoiled. We don't want that happening. But let's hop into this freaking list! 1. The opening of Felina takes place entirely on a soundstage. 2. Originally, Vince wanted to have sub-freezing temperatures on set to show Walt's breath, but the easiest way to do that ended up being to put a dry ice capsule in Bryan Cranston's mouth. 3. Walt knocking the snow off the window was improvised. 4. Many people look at the title Felina and often refer to its meaning as finale in Spanish and as an anagram for blood, tears, and meth, something like that, but Vince puts it a different way. The title of the episode, Felina, is referring to the woman in the song that played in the teaser. Vince chose to spell the name differently in order to have Felina also mean finale. 5. Walt using the payphone at the gas station was the last sequence shot for the finale. 6. This episode was the only Breaking Bad episode that featured two DPs, or two directors of photography. 7. Elliot's car headlights being on and off was done through computer graphics. On set, the car headlights were completely off. 8. In this scene, inside this set, no food or drink was allowed. This caused Vince to become so dehydrated that the next day he needed to have an IV pump fluids into him. 9. This fire POV shot was done using a mirror by the fire and then was flipped in the editing room. 10. Compiling all the fake money onto the table was a big pain, according to Bryan Cranston. 11. Gretchen had only one day to film her scenes. In order to achieve this, her final scene in the show had to be shot during the filming of Granite State, the previous episode of Breaking Bad. 12. Speaking of Gretchen, the actress's husband is Adam Bernstein, one of the directors from Breaking Bad's first season. 13. The laser pointer bit in the scene was done practically. No film trickery was needed. 14. When Bryan Cranston was doing the commentary for the finale, it was actually his first time watching the finished product. Unfortunately, he had to watch it without sound. 15. The location where Walt meets Skinny Pete and Badger is up the hill from the bar location Walt was at in the last episode. 16. Michelle McLaren shot and directed the Jesse flashback scene due to Vince running out of time filming the finale. 17. Walt taking the ricin from his house was the last time Vince collaborated with Michael Slovis, the go-to director of photography for Breaking Bad. 18. The waiter in the scene where Walt meets Lydia works in the location scouting department. He's been around since the pilot episode. Like what you've seen so far, be sure to subscribe! 91% ain't subbing! Come on. It's free. It helps me out. DBAA, yo! We got more Breaking Bad and Better Call Saul content coming for you to enjoy, so subscribe and leave a like, come on! Anyway, enough of that, let's get back into the list. 19. It was Brian's idea to have Walt's wedding ring slip out from his shirt, reminding him of his family while out in the desert. 20. Marie's bodyguard is Vince Gilligan's helicopter pilot instructor, who was also there to help Vince film aerial scenes back in the X-File days. Vince never did finish that flight program.
21?
Skyler's new house is a set, but it was built after a real apartment interior from the complex shown on screen. While location scouting, they came up with the idea of the wood post in the middle in order to conceal Walt's presence. 22. The main camera operator started to cry during Walt and Skyler's final moment. It was a very touching moment for everyone involved. 23. The lottery ticket is fake in this close-up shot. Real New Mexico lottery tickets don't have six numbers. 24. Melissa Bernstein, one of the writers and producers of the show, can be seen in the bus two seats back, which is a reference to her being a student riding in a school bus in the pilot episode. 25. Dave Porter, the composer, advocated for no music during the scene with Skyler and Walt. 26. When the henchmen showed Walt's key fob to the others outside, it was actually black, and they had to digitally paint the key fob its proper color. 27. The interior of Uncle Jack's clubhouse was very difficult to shoot in because the walls could not be moved like their other sets. Why couldn't they be moved? Well, In fact, there were 7 miles of explosives wired behind the walls. 28. This set only had one door allowing people in and out, which proved difficult in lugging in equipment and swapping out stand-ins. 29. The sound of the massage chair comes from Vince's real massage chair at home. 30. The massage chair itself was fake. To create the effect that it was working, 3 airbags were stuffed inside and were rigged manually to inflate and deflate. 31. The shot of the ceiling shortly after the shootout, it's a lot of S's, required putting a hole in the ceiling. 32. The blood that gets splattered on the lens was done by placing plexiglass right in front of the camera lens, plus using a compressed air container to create the splatter, and adding in a digital module, and adding in a digital muzzle flash. Jeez. 33. When Walt says, "I want this," it was really the first time Walt told the truth to Jesse, in Brian's words. 34. It was pure coincidence that the dial in the lab said Weiss, meaning white in German. 35. Vince comments on the last song saying, quote, "There needs to be a sense of triumph and sadness and bittersweetness. That's how Walt's story should end." And 36. According to Vince, throughout the entire finale, Walt planned to have Jesse killed in the shooting, but something in Walt made him involuntarily, quote-unquote, jump in to save Jesse's life. How sweet. Breaking Bad ended over 10 years ago, and I still get emotional watching the finale. But that's just because I'm a cave-dwelling loser. Anyway, I hope you guys and gals learned something new today. If so, be sure to check out the plethora of other Breaking Bad content I cooked up for you. You can click right here to see the catalog on the channel. But other than that, thanks for watching. Be sure to leave a like on the video. Comment, leave a comment if you leave a comment. Subscribe if you're new. Between me, you, Vincey, and Heisenberg, have a wonderful day, and peace out.